السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. ربي أعوذ بك من همزات الشياطين وأعوذ بك ربي أن يحضرون. Suppose you are walking along a narrow path. On both sides there are walls. Then you see one cobra and you be frightened. Okay? Then what will be your response? Or whom do you call for help at that time?
Allah.
You will say, Ya Allah. Because you know only Allah can help you. Only He can help you. He is the creator. Allah is the creator of the universe. Okay? Then He is the creator of mankind. He is the creator of man. Okay? Then see, if one person in a junior class or one boy in your class attacks or beats the other fellow, other boy, his neighbor, then what will you think about that boy? Will you think he's a good boy?
No.
Now, you say he's a bad boy. Or at least you say his action of attacking the other person, other boy, is not good. It's a bad action. So, we know there are something, some actions which are good and some actions which are bad. Yes. So, there are good things and bad things. Or virtue and vice is there. Good and bad is there. Okay. So, how will we differentiate between this bad things and good things? Which thing is good? Or which action is good? Which deed is good? And which deed is bad? How do we come to know it? So, actually, this we know because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the furqan. That is, we are given a choice, or we are given in mind that the something is wrong and the other thing is right. Like that. So, here when we live in this world, we have to obey certain rules. And these rules or laws are given by the Creator Himself. So because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us, He has to give us rules. Okay? Only He can give us rules. Or only Allah can give us the laws which we should follow. Okay? Then only we will be successful. Okay? So, you know, the first man on earth was Adam alayhi salam. The first man. Abul Bashar Adam alayhi salam. The first woman. Our mother. Hawa radhiyallahu anha. So, both of them were created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then He sent them as a khalifa to the earth. Okay? So, here in this earth we are living. So, during the time of Prophet Adam alayhi salam and Hawa radhiyallahu anha, and there were springs. That time, the society was very, very simple. Very less people. Less in number. Okay? Very few people were there. So, the rules were very simple. How to live? That rules given by Allah. For Adam alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave 10 sahifa, 10 suhfa. 10 edul Adam alayhi salam. So, according to that sahifa or suhfa, they lived. You know, during that time, only brothers and sisters were there. Their brothers and sisters. Born to same mother and father, Adam and Hawa. During that time, during the early period, this early period of mankind, that time, brother could marry sister. Brother could marry his sister. But now, we can't. But now, the society is very complex. So, when the society became complex, the humanity developed so much, some rules were to be amended. Then who should amend the rules? We have power to amend the rules, change the rules, change the laws. To change the laws, we have no ability or we have no power, we have no authority at all. Only Allah can change the rules. Okay, so gradually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent so many messengers from among men themselves. Okay, we call them Anbiya, Anbiya, Nabis, Nabi Marnum, prophets. So, different prophets were sent to the different parts of the world. And the last and final messenger is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our beloved prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, so many Vedas, the scriptures were given or revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through these messengers to the mankind. You know, our the fourth Veda or the fourth scripture from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the last and final scripture is Quran. Quran. It's also called Al-Furqan. This, it differentiates between the good and evil. The good and bad. That's why it's called Al-Furqan. Furqan means that which differentiates between good and evil. Yeah. Or good and bad. Okay. Then, so, you know, to Prophet Moses, the kitab revealed was
Taurat.
Taurat. Then, to Prophet Dawood or King David, Prophet David, the kitab revealed was
Zabur.
The Psalms, in Malayalam we call Sangeertanangal, the Old Testament, the Bible, that we call Sangeertanangal. But it is only the distorted version. It's not the actual or original form of the kitab. The original kitab is no more. Okay? Only Quran is there in the original form. All other previous scriptures were distorted by its people. Okay? You know, Injil was revealed to whom?
Isa
alayhi salam. Prophet Isa alayhi salam. Prophet Jesus alayhi salam. Injil. That we call New Testament. That also is not the original Injil. It's also not the original Injil. So, the original version, as it is revealed here, is the Holy Quran, the final word of Allah, or the final message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, Quran, we start to learn the Holy Quran, the preface. You know, the first verses of Holy Quran revealed, the first verses revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes, you recite.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq al-insana min 'alaq. Iqra wa rabbuka al-akram. الذي أنكم بالقلم
الذي علم بالقلم
علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم
اقرأ read بسم ربك الذي خلق اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق اقرأ read بسم بالتنعيم ربك of your Lord رب means
Lord.
الَّذِي خَلَقْ Who has created you. So, you read in the name of your Lord who has created you. Okay. You read the first command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the humanity, to the Muslim, is to read. To read in the name of your Lord. That is in the name of Allah. You are correct. Then, read in the name of your Lord who has created you. اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق. He created. خلق means
created.
الإنسان
humans.
Human beings. The man. He created the man from علق. خلق الإنسان من علق. من علق from a clot. From a clot. A clinging. Clot called alaq, in the womb of the mother. Okay, Adam was first created from turab, that is
soil,
clay. Yes. clay. That is the correct word. Clay. Turab. Then, you know, kullukum min Adam. Wa Adam min turab. All of you are from Adam. All of you are from Adam. And wa Adam min turab. And Adam is from?
Turab.
That is clay. Okay. So, the first creation of man was from
clay.
Then Adam, Hawa was created. His wife was created from Adam. Then through sexual reproduction, this humankind developed. Okay. So that's why it's called خلق الإنسان من علق. علق, that clot which clings to the womb of the mother, in the uterus. It's called it. Alaq. Halaq al-insana min alaq. Uterus, you know? Mara? Garbashya. Garbashya. Garbashya, you know? Utti piti chikku nana. Alaq first. Utti piti chikku nana. Pinna adang nana. Halaq al-insana min alaq. Iqra. You read. Warabbuka al-akram. So, those verses were revealed first. Okay. Then, with the 23 years, so many verses were revealed at different times, different situations. All these were compiled by the command of Allah. And the first chapter given is Al-Fatiha, not Taqara Bismi Rabbika Alladhi Khalaq. Okay, so it is arranged not in the order of revelation, but the order is prescribed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is compiled, and it is the order of compilation is prescribed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself. So first chapter, he said, it is Al-Fatiha. It is Al-Fatiha in Holy Quran. In the Mus'haf, you see, the first chapter is, the first surah is? The first surah of Holy Quran is? Al-Fatiha. How many surahs or how many chapters are there?
114.
Yes, very good. 114 chapters are there. So about 6,200 plus verses or ayat are there. So in the first chapter, you see, there are how many verses?
Seven
verses are there. Can you recite this Al-Fatiha?
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين. So when you recited, first you recited what? أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. It is called استعذاب or تعبد. استعذاب. Seeking refuge with Allah. Seeking refuge with Allah from the cursed Satan. Okay, it is called isti'adha or ta'abud. You call it ta'abud. A'udhu billahi min shaytan al-wajim. It is not a part of the Quran here. In Al-Fatiha. Okay? But we are commanded or ordered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِذَا قَرَأْتَ الْقُرْآنَ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ. Whenever you recite the Quran, you should seek refuge with Allah from the Satan. Okay? That's why we say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Because Satan may interfere with this recitation. Satan did not like good things. Reciting Holy Quran or performing Salah, it is not liked by Satan. It is evil. He is evil. Okay. He will inspire us to good, bad things for you. Okay. So, to avoid the interruption by Satan, we or temptation, to avoid his temptation, we should recite what? A'udhu billahi minash shaytani rajim. A'udhu means I seek refuge. A'udhu, I seek refuge. Billahi, with Allah. Minash shaytani, from the Satan. Ar-rajim, the cursed one. The one was cursed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, cursed Satan. So that is A'udhu billahi minash shaytani. The next, the first verse of Surah Al-Fatiha. There are differences of opinion among the scholars, among the Muslim scholars, whether Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is the first verse or not. Some say that it is just an introduction or a beginning. Alright? Just a starting. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The first verse is Alhamdulillah ar-Rahman. There are so many hadiths supporting this view. Okay. The other group of scholars, they say that Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is the first verse. So, whatever you follow, no problem. Anything, you can follow. Any view. Both are good. Okay. So, those people who advocate that Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is the first verse, they will recite it aloud in the prayer. In the Salah. Others will recite Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim in a low voice. Then they will start with Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Okay. Then Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. It is called Basmala. Ready? Basmala. Bismillah. You said Bismi or Bismillah. Basmala. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. It means?
In the name of Allah,
Allah.
The infinitely compassionate and merciful.
Yes. In the name of Allah, Bismillah. Bismillah means in the name of Allah. Allah. Masmuk? 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 Your name?
Sajjad.
Yes. Masmuk, what's your name? Masmuk? What's your name? So, Isma means?
Name.
Bismi, B means with. Bismi, with the name. Bismillah. With whose name? You will start?
Allah.
Allah. Bismillah, in the name of Allah. Or with the name of Allah. By the name of Allah. With the name of Allah. In the name of Allah. We start. Abda'u Bismillah. So actually, Abda'u, I start. Bada'a means start. Start. Abda'u, I start. Bismillah. With the name of Allah. In the name of Allah. Ar-Rahman. Ar-Rahman. The infinitely compassionate. Or his mercy is surrounded by all. To all. His mercy is there. So, Mubalaghat. He said, Rahman and Rahim. Both denotes mercy. Merciful. Gracious. Beneficent, both have the same meaning actually. But Rahman is greater mercy. It shows greater mercy. Mubalaghat is mubalaghat. So we can say limitless mercy or infinitely merciful, infinitely compassionate. Rahman, Rahman. So Rahman, the word, the name cannot be given to anyone. Okay, only Allah is Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, the especially merciful. To whom? To the believers. To the believers. To the muttaqeen. Where? Here or in the hereafter?
Yeah.
Hereafter. So, Ar-Rahim means the one who show mercy to, one who shows mercy to the believers who obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who obeyed Rasulullah. So Allah will show mercy to the believers who obeyed Him in the hereafter. So those who disobeyed, for those who were arrogant, they will not get mercy in the hereafter from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will not get mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But here, in this world, He will give mercy. He will give blessings to every person. Whether he is a believer or not, Allah is not checking that. He will give wealth, property. He will give luxury. He will give everything that is needed for the sustenance, for the life of the human being. Whether he is a believer or not. That Allah will not check. He is giving blessings to kafir also. Okay. He is giving mercy to or blessing to atheist also. Atheist means one who disbelieves in God. Atheist. Nirishwarvadi. Atheist. So Allah gives his blessings, his rahmat to the atheist also. Atheist means one who believes that there is no God. Okay. Such a person is called an atheist. Polytheist means one who believes that there are so many gods. So many gods deserves to be worshipped. Poly means many. Polytheist means one who believes in so many gods. The existence of so many ilah. But they say, Al-ilah. The one deserves to be worshipped. Lord, the Lord. So, Al-Ilah is a Al plus Ilah, Allah. La ilaha illallah. There is none deserves to be worshipped except
Allah.
There is none deserves. There is no Ilah at all except Allah. But Allah. Okay. So, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the infinitely compassionate and the especially merciful. No? In the name of Allah, we start. No? Just we started only. Okay? Just we started only. Okay? No. Next verse. Recite. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. After that?
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil
Alameen. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdu, all praises, Alhamdu, Lillahi,
to Allah.
All praises to Allah, Rabbil Alameen,
Lord
of the worlds, or all the worlds. So there are so many words which we know and we don't know. No, there are so many stars. Sun is the nearest star to earth. Nearest star. The sun. The sun, the earth, Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter, then Saturn, all these are planets which revolve around the sun. The earth also revolves around the sun. So this we call the sun. The planets including the earth and the comets. Materials. All these together we call what?
Universe.
No, before that. Universe. No. Bigger. Part of universe. Yes.
Solar system.
Solar system. So, like that, so many solar systems are there. And so many solar systems come together we call sometimes one galaxy. One galaxy. Our galaxy. That is the galaxy which will include our solar system is called Milky Way. It's called it?
Milky Way.
And there are so many galaxies just like or resembling this, similar to Milky Way. And so many galaxies are there. Okay? So many galaxies. So many constellations, galaxies. So many stars. The sun is only one among them. So there are billions of stars. So this world, very, very wide and large. You don't know. It's a boundary. You don't know. Here, in this earth, still, that earth itself is big. Okay? Okay. So we are living here in this earth. On other planets also, sometimes there will be some creatures, some living things like that. Only Allah knows. Okay? Then. So, for the whole world. No, in the hereafter, that's also a world. The heavens, the hell fire, swarga naraka, jannat and nar, all these are words. Then the words of the micro world, you know, microscopic small beings are there, living organisms, so small germs which we can't see with our naked eyes, okay, only with the help of powerful microscope. So many words are there. Actually, those words, some words which we know, some which we don't know. So, the creator or the lord of the whole world, Rabbul Alameen. Rabb means one who creates and then gives its sustenance, maintains it and protects it. Such one is called Rabb. So, Rabb, Allahu Anadilam Sritichi Paribarichi Vodhu. So, Rabbul Alameen. Allah is the Rabbul Alameen. Rabbul Alameen means Yusa. Lord of the worlds. Alam means world. Alameen is plural form. Plural form, you know? Plural. Plural Malatan Dore. Bahuvachanam. Singular?
Ekavachanam.
Boy. Walad. Boy. Walad. This Mufrad. Mufrad in Arabic. Singular. Aulad or boys. Is that it? Plural. Bahuvachanam. Alam, Alameen. So, not the Quran uses the word Alameen. Lord of the worlds. Not the Lord of the world. Loganadan Allah. Logangaludan Allah. Lord of the worlds. Means Lord of all the worlds. So, how many worlds are there? We don't know. Anyhow, all the worlds. Lord of all the worlds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who is the Lord of all the worlds?
Allah
subhanahu wa ta'ala. So praise. So worthy of praise is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Worthy of hamd. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. We say alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Tahmeed. We call it this? Tahmeed. We call it this? Tahmeed. Subhanallah. We call it this? Tasbeeh. Call it this?
Tasbeeh.
Tahleel, we call it. La ilaha illallah. So, all creatures, whether anything living or non-living, they praise us Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Voluntarily or involuntarily. Praises are different. Different types. All living beings or non-living things praise us or subject to Allah's rules. Now, so Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. No, see, you said the meaning. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praises.
Praise be to Allah.
Without looking into it. All praises
to Allah. Lord of all the worlds.
Lord of all the worlds. You say, you also say. Yes. All praises to Allah. Say.
All praises to Allah.
Yes. Lord of
all the worlds.
Lord of all the worlds. Alhamdu, you say. You are all. All praises. Alhamdu, all praises. Lillahi to Allah. To Allah. Lillahi. Lillahi. Rabbil Alameen. Lord of
all the worlds.
Very good. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praises to Allah. Lord of all the worlds. Once more. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. You say, all of them.
Praise be to Allah, Lord of all the worlds.
All praises to Allah, Lord of
all the worlds.
Okay. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All the worlds. Lord of all the worlds. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. The infinitely compassionate and especially merciful. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم then
مالك
يوم الدين مالك so then slanting is that England slanting مالك not مالك يوم الدين مالك يوم الدين. مالك means owner. مالك means
owner.
يوم يوم means
day.
نهار day. يوم نهار يوم. ليلة
night.
يوم الدين means the day of recompense, the day of rewards, the day of accounting, the day of reckoning. Now, so we do here good things and bad things. So there'll be reward for it. There'll be a result. Result we get where? In the here or hereafter?
Hereafter.
So the result the will be in the hereafter. So result giving day or the reward giving day is called Yawmuddin. Yawmul Qiyamah. It's called Yawmul Qiyamah. The last day. The final day. Yeah? So that day we call Yawmuddin. The day of recompense. The day of recompense. Or the day of accounting. Or the day of reckoning. Accounting. Kanakkeduppu divasam. Annu prathifalam nalga. Rewards will be given. Good or evil. Good reward will be there for good believers. And the reward of the disbelievers, the arrogant people, will be the hellfire. Naru jahanna. Hellfire. Hellfire means in Malayalam? Naraka. Maliki yawmiddin. So, we praised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the Lord of all the worlds. And all praises belongs to him. He is infinitely compassionate. That is his compassion or his mercy, his bounty or his ni'mat, his rahmat is limitless without any boundary, without limit, without limit. We can't count it. We can't count. Can we count the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us? No. It is limitless. It is limitless. So we say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ar-Rahman. And Ar-Rahim. Ar-Rahim, the especially compassionate, the especially merciful, the especially gracious to the believers in the hereafter. So in the hereafter, he will not show mercy at all to the disbelievers. Because he has given guidance. He has given guidance. He has given the choice of freedom to select good or evil. Yeah? Then if man selects the evil things, the evil path, the wrong path, then he will be put in the hellfire, no doubt at all. Okay? Eh? Follow. Yes. You follow? Okay. Then. Maliki yawmiddin. Then we say, what? He is the owner of the day of recompense. But now also he is the owner. Now also he is the owner. He is the owner of this dunya, this world. Actually, we say, I am the owner of this house. Actually, the owner is who?
Allah
subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has given me this. So, there a limited power is given to me. Here, in this world. Okay? A limited power is given. Eh? Maal or property, wealth is given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, actually, the owner is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That we know. Still we say, that property belongs to such person, that property belongs to Sajjabi, that property belongs to Mubashira, like that. Eh? But you know, Allah gave us the property. Allah gave us the house. Allah gave us the property, the wealth, everything, the house, everything. Eh? Still, we say, so there is a limited power for us here. That is given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But in the hereafter, everything will belong to Allah. No one can interfere. There is no choice at all for us to select. Only, can we select heaven or hell there? No. So, here we can select good and bad things. Allah has given us some freedom. Freedom. In Malayalam?
Swatantra.
So, Allah has given us freedom to select good or bad things. So, we should select what? Good things. So, but angels, they can select only good things. They can select bad things. But we are created not like that. We have given a choice of free will. Eh? We have to select good some people. Good only. Eh? There is good path and We have so many wrong paths, evil paths. But we have to select what?
Good path,
the straight path. So that's why, in the next verse, we see, before that, we say, a pledge. We will take a pledge before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is, the next verse, Maliki Yawmiddin, after that?
Iyaka
na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. Iyaka, you alone. Iyaka na'budu, we worship, allowed, we worship. Wa iyaka, and you alone. Nasta'in, we ask for help. So, we worship you alone, only you. Who?
Allah.
So, in front of Allah, before Allah, we say what? We take a pledge that take before Allah. You alone do we worship, and you alone do we ask for
help.
Okay, that's why when we were moving through that narrow way, during the night, when we saw the cobra, he asked, he cried, Ya Allah, cried, Ya Allah, help me, Ya Allah, Allah, only Allah can help us. So, sometimes we may get help from others, from the creations, but actually the help comes from Allah. Allah entrusts that person to help us. Sometimes we will be in misery, we will be poor. Then some other person who have money may give us some money. Okay. Actually, Allah sends that person to us to help us. So eventually, the real helper is who?
Allah
subhanahu wa ta'ala. So eventually, the help comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So actually, only Allah can help. So we should seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should seek help. Isti'anat, it is called isti'anat. So ibadat and isti'anat, both these two terms connected with Allah. We worship Allah alone. Not only we worship Allah, we worship Allah alone. We should worship Him alone. Only Allah. No others, no prophets. Prophets are there. But we should not worship the prophets. We should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, if we ask for forgiveness, istighfar, astaghfirullah, shall we say, astaghfir Muhammad Rasulullah? He says, no. We know, istighfar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should ask for forgiveness, not to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man, sent by Allah, but he had divine revelation, wahy. Okay, divine revelation. He received messages from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he gave that message to mankind, to the whole mankind. He has given the message. Allah's message is given by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in. You alone do we worship, and to you alone we ask for
help.
No others. We will ask for help to you alone. To you, Allah. Alone. Then, now, our demand is that so till this time, we praised Allah. We took a pledge that we will worship only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we will ask for Him only. Then we had to say something to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's our demand. What is that? Next verse. إياك نستعين then اهدنا الصراط المستقيم اهدنا you
guide
us الصراط the path Al-Mustaqeem. Straight. Not the curved path. Not the curved path. You guide us on the straight path. You guide us to the straight path. Neraya margathil njangal aakkiyathu. Hidayat. We ask to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, to get this thing, to say this thing, Hidayat. Sirat al-Mustaqeem. We are in front of Allah. Till this time. Okay. What is our demand? Our only demand is to get Hidayat from Allah to the straight path. To the Sirat al-Mustaqeem. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين صراط a path الذين أنعمت عليهم the path of those who have whom you blessed or upon whom your favors غير المغضوب عليهم not the path of those upon whom your anger or wrath befall ولا الضالين and not the path of those who wander astray wander here and there without seeing the right path they are wandering here and there the curved paths not the straight path. Okay. So, As-Sirat al-Mustaqeem. As-Sirat al-Mustaqeem. That's our demand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That we are asking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, in the next chapter, we shall discuss later. Al-Baqarah. There, the verse starts. Alif Lam Mim. Dhalika al-kitabu la rayba fi. Hudan lil muttaqin. Dhalikal kitab. This is the book. This is the book. No. You are asking. No, this is the book. This is the book. Dhalikal kitab. This is the book. Dhalikal kitab. La rayba fi. There is no doubt at all. No doubt at all. This is the book. No, there is no doubt at all. Hudan lil muttaqin. It is guidance. Huda. To the muttaqin. To the righteous. To the pious people. So we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Fatiha, the preface of Al-Quran, what? Hidayat, Surah Al-Mustaqeem, Huda. Then Allah says, that, here it is, Huda is there. Where? Huda. Yeah. Alif Lam Mim. Dhalika al-kitab. La rayba fihi. Now this is the book. No doubt in it. Where it is Huda. For you, the pious people, the righteous people. So, we should learn this. Okay? We should learn and follow this. What? Holy Quran. Holy Quran. So, in all our day-to-day prayers, how many times prayers?
Five times.
Compulsory prayers, Surat al-Maktuba is there. In all those prayers, all raka'ats, we recite what? Surah al-Fatiha. There also, in Fatiha, we ask the guidance, the Huda, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.